Hi, this is Jen Lasser with Adobe Analytics Product Management. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to use the Flow Visualization and Analysis Workspace, which has recently been improved. The Flow Visualization helps you understand the exact journeys your customers are taking through your website or your app. For example, if you wanted to know what pages people are viewing in the exact order that they're viewing them, you can use the Flow Visualization. You can add a Flow Viz from either a blank panel or from the left visualization rail. To start, you'll have three options. You can either place a dimension in the entry zone, the middle node, or the exit zone, depending on how you want to anchor your Flow Viz. So, for example, if we wanted to look at pages on our website or our app, we could drop that in the middle node here. What will result is the top page for the time frame that we're looking at as the focus node in the middle. And then you'll see all the top pages leading into that page of home and out of that page of home. If you hover over different parts of the flow, you'll expose more information. So you'll see some interesting data points related to the home page here. It has about 141,000 entries, which you can see here, and 24,000 exits. And then you'll be able to hover over each of these paths to understand what percentage of total path views are accounted for here. You can interact with Flow completely by clicking on any one of the nodes and expanding to the left or to the right. Additionally, we've added in some settings to this Flow visualization. The first is the container. We'll default to a visitor container, which will let you look at the flow of people moving across different sessions or different visits. The visit container will constrain this visualization to just within the same session. You can also choose to wrap the labels you see on the flow visualization, which you'll notice takes those truncated words and wraps them. And then the new option of include repeat instances. Flow visualizations are now based on instances only. So if you're pathing on something like an evar or a list var, you'll have persistence removed from the flow. But instances can also repeat. For example, if you reload a page, that would count as a repeated instance. So we've given you the option to either include or exclude those repeated instances. By default, we will exclude the repeated instances. So you'll never see, for example, home flow into itself within the same flow visualization. I want to give you a couple more examples of how to use the flow visualization. Not only can you drop in the page dimension, which is probably the leading use case of flow, but you can also use any other dimension that you are collecting into Adobe Analytics, things like evars or multi-valued vars. For example, you can bring over marketing channel. What results is the top marketing channels that people have entered your brand on. So here we see email is the top entry marketing channel. And what's neat is you can continue to expand this out to see what the next marketing touch point is after email. Because we have deduped instances removed, you'll only see email lead to non-email channels. I'll give you one more example. And that is that you can do mixed dimensions in flow. Not only can you path on props, evars, multi-valued vars, but you can mix those together as well. For example, if you wanted to understand all the pages that people enter on and then the subsequent internal search terms that they look for, you could bring over the page dimension. Once that renders, you could bring over the internal search term dimension. You have the option to replace, but in this case, we'll just add. And now what we see in the flow visualization is all of the top terms that people are searching for from the home page. This is a great opportunity to optimize your different entry pages here for the right content so that when your visitors land, they don't have to go and search for something that they're looking for. They can find it right on the page that they've entered on. So if you haven't used the flow visualization before, definitely check it out. It's a great way, again, to visualize the journeys that your customers have with your brand. And with the new addition of being able to remove repeated instances, the results of this visualization are even more actionable.